So this is Dove soap is good. Their soaps like Vanny Cream, they're gentle, they're mild. They're not going to have very harsh detergents that are going to over dry the skin. They're going to be able to remove any kind of dirt, debris, when and if you wear any type of powder on the skin or anything like that, it can help remove that as well. So it's an easy way to just kind of gently cleanse the skin without overstripping the oils that we were talking about earlier. Because if you're drier, then your skin's gonna make more oil, and if you make more oil, then you can start to break out, okay? So always number one, gentle cleanser. The next thing we have, and this is just a sample, because I didn't want to give you, Blue Lizard is, it's for all ages. This is a sports one. So I put this in here because if you're sweating or in a pool, some sunscreens won't stay on. They're not gonna be waterproof. So you always want, if you know you're gonna be outside, you know you're gonna be sweating, if you know you're gonna be in a pool or around water, you always wanna make sure you find one that's a sport, meaning that it won't wash off or deactivate in the water. On a daily basis, you see right here where it says the number 30? Mm-hmm. That's what you wanna look for on a moisturizer that you put on the skin during the daytime. So that way we're protecting the skin throughout the day. Even going from here to the car, those little 15 seconds of sun, just boom, 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 it adds up over time, okay? So that's why we wanna protect the skin. So a little bit of moisturizer. There are, some people use coconut oil, shea butter, and they never have any issues at all, and their skin looks fabulous. If you start feeling like your skin starts feeling a little bit either oilier or greasier over time, you may have to switch to a lighter facial moisturizer, which is just a lighter lotion that's just made for the face, as opposed to a thicker moisturizer for the rest of the body, okay? And then, body moisturizer. Gotta keep everything looking nice and moisturized. So I always say when you're doing body moisturizers, find something that's a cream, or it's in a jar that you can scoop out, or it's in a tube that you can squeeze out. If you could pump it out of a bottle, it has too much water in there, and usually in about 15, 20 minutes, you're gonna be dry all over again because all that water is evaporated. So creams, ointments like Vaseline, or anything that's really in a cream in a tube or in a jar is best for you, okay? So this is heavier, so it's good for the body, but you don't wanna put too heavy of a moisturizer on the face. And then, this is all thanks for a secret. And then, does anyone have any older ladies in the family? Over 30. A little night cream. Not for you, but for your mentors. And then we have a little soap essential hairband for everybody just to enjoy. So these are just kind of little simple steps. Cleanser, moisturize. In the morning, and if you do it at nighttime as well, cleanser, moisturize. Okay.
I think the soap ones for your face, the ones they have scrubs in them, like new ones. Is that good for your face too?
That's okay. If you feel like your skin gets really sensitive afterwards, you don't have to do that. A nice little natural scrub that I make and do on myself sometimes. I get honey, and I just get coconut sugar. You just mix it together and you just do little circles with a little water and it exfoliates everything. The honey is a natural antibacterial agent and the coconut sugar is the exfoliant that scrubs the skin, but it's not too harsh and too irritating to the skin. Did you use exfoliants or completely fine? So wash the scalp with that shampoo, which is kind of like washing the skin with the soap. And then when you want to moisturize and condition the hair, your scalp doesn't need that per se because you have all those oil glands that are going to pump oil into the scalp. So you want to moisturize and condition the hair. So a lot of times, and you know, I was in the old school where it's like, you know, grease your scalp, moisturize your scalp, but your scalp makes all that oil on a daily basis. So what happens if you put extra oil on, you can easily clog pores, or can cause other issues, or you can actually feed natural yeast that's there. Everyone has natural yeast on their scalp. It keeps the good and the bad bacteria in line. But when it overgrows, it starts making the scalp itchy, flaky, and dandruff occurs. That's one reason dandruff can occur. And so when you put oil on a scalp, then you're actually feeding that natural yeast. So people say, oh, it's itchy, it's dry, it's flaky, and they put oil on there. Well, you're just feeding the problem. So that's why we treat that when it gets really out of control. And nothing. So I always tell individuals if they're shaving to not use straight blades, but to use kind of trimmers which can give you the same effect, but it's, they're not straight blades that can cut the skin. It's more little rotor rooters in there that can cut the hairs, but everything can feel smooth afterwards. So you don't have to worry about either ingrown hairs or worry about cutting the skin that can leave behind the neck. So around at the opening of that pore, it tints up just a little bit. So it's a little bit raised compared to the surrounding skin. So when you're going over those hair follicles, you're not just cutting the hair, you're cutting a little bit of that skin on both sides. So that's why it causes a little bit of tiny sore and it can leave behind a little scar tissue or a little bit of a dark spot. If you do have the dots, then sometimes we have to either do something called chemical peels, or we can do like creams that can help fade out those areas. But they're tricky because they're, you know, a lot of little dots. Yes, ma'am.
It was like, how powerful can tropical solution get? Because like my pediatrician ended up like a long time ago gave me a cream, and my skin immediately started like flaming up, and then like it started really peeling, and it was bad because I was going to school the next day, and so everybody was like, "What's wrong with your face? It looks ashy." And I was like, and I didn't know what was going on, but my mom got mad. She threw away all the medication, and she gave me like some type of weird turmeric mask. She just gave me, you know, natural remedies.
I love turmeric. Turmeric's a good anti-inflammatory. They can be very strong. I mean, they're topical solutions, whereas it can literally give you a burn. So that's why it's really important that your doctor knows how your skin reacts to things and how sensitive it is. Because there's a lot of things we can prescribe or recommend over the counter. So it's really just kind of seeing how your skin has responded to things in the past to know how mild or how tolerable it can be. It can be strong.
What can you use to get rid of excess oily skin?
For oily skin, we kind of talk a little bit about diet, making sure there's like fruits and vegetables, a lot of kind of just raw foods that are included, a lot less kind of processed foods. And then we can do topical creams. Like there's a little cream that's derived from a vitamin A medicine that can help with oil production. Sometimes we give little kind of mattifying creams that you can put on the skin to try to reduce the oils from making oils throughout the day. So there are things that we do, but usually I try to find out what may be the source that's causing the changes in the skin and address those.